Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create cartoon eyes in Affinity Designer. So to get started, I have some various shapes of eyes, and you can determine which shapes you like and which fit your style best. The approach I'm going to share with you today could be applied to any shape or color eye. So let's take a look at the pair of eyes down here, and let's get started. Okay, so to get started here, I'm going to select my Ellipse tool. I'm going to hold shift to create a perfect circle. I will come over here to my side panel, and I will duplicate that circle and now drag it inside of our first circle. With that circle still selected, I will hold control and shift to resize it. And we'll go ahead and we'll select a blue for this eye here. I'm going to open that up and come in here and select duplicate that circle as well. And now you can see it resized that second circle based on how much we had proportioned for the first circle. So we'll go ahead and select black for the people here. So you can see this is the base of the eyeball here. And one thing that I like to do is I like to kind of create this shine on either side of the eyeball. And a way that we could do that is if we go ahead and take this blue ellipse and duplicate it, we'll make it, let me say, a purple. And I'm going to resize it a bit here. I will now duplicate this purple and we'll make this, say, red so we can see it a little bit better. My move tool, move it around just a little bit. This purple ellipse here is what's going to make up the actual white shine on the eyeball itself, okay? So we want to look at how much of that purple shape is showing, and that's how much white we will have left behind. So that looks pretty decent there. So with my kind of pink circle selected, I will go ahead and hold shift and select the purple as well. Coming up here, I will hit the subtract button, which leaves then just this purple. Move that up a hair, and we could change that to white. Now I like to come over to quick effects. We'll scroll down to Gaussian blur. And we'll just pull that up around 14 pixels or so. Something else I like to go ahead and do at this stage here is click on one of these cogwheels, come in here and select scale with object. That way when we go to resize the eye, it'll keep the proportions of the effects and they won't get all blown out and blurry and all of that. Another thing that I'm going to go ahead and do with this white highlight selected is I'm going to click on the transparency tool and I'm going to drag from the direction where I want most of the light. So I want most of the light to stay on this side here, and I want this to kind of fade off into darkness. So I'm gonna drag here, and you can see, depending on how much I pull that in, how much light is being let into this section. So the transparency tool is pretty cool. It will give you some pretty neat effects like that. Now we can go ahead and simply duplicate this shape as well. I can hold Alt to duplicate and create a new shape. And we'll go ahead and come up here and flip horizontal and then flip vertical, get it to mirror to the other side. All right, now let's work on the rest of the eye. So something that I like to do for the main color section is I'll come into quick effects and outer shadow. I'll bump the opacity up to about 70 to 80% or so, just depending on what looks good. And I'll also bump up the radius. So you can see I've kind of got that shadow ring around the color section now. And that looks pretty good. So anywhere around the 35 to probably 40 pixels. But that just gives me a little bit of depth. I'm not going to change the angle of the drop shadow or add any offset. Again, I'll click on this cogwheel. Scale with objects. This is something that I always tend to make sure I remember to do. Okay, also with the blue circle, I'd like to go ahead and add a gradient. I'll add a radial gradient. I'm going to come out from the center here. I'll make this point a little closer, maybe about midway. We'll come down the radial. Now, we've got a nice light section in the middle, and it gets darker around the edge. Another way we could go ahead and enhance that effect is by coming up to our black ellipse, the pupil itself. We'll come up to quick effects again. If I go and come down here to outer glow, go ahead and bump that radius up quite a bit. Now I'm going to select the color. I'm going to move it to something closer to the blue that we have here, right? So now it matches a little bit more and gives it a little bit more of that light feeling behind the pupil itself. So continuing on. I'll come in here, and now I want to add the highlights. And there's a couple of different ways you could do it. You could do it similar to how I did it up here with an ellipse and then a circle, but you do want them on opposite sides of the eye. So for instance, if we have the light coming in here, our main specular highlight will be where the light is coming in and hitting it. But then due to the bounce and reflected light, it'll throw some light over here on this side. So what we'll go ahead and do with these is I'll switch this down here. I'm going to make this smaller. Hold Control and Shift to resize it around center. It's more of a medium circle there. And I'm going to take one more, make this one even smaller. And then we have a look like that. Come back over to my Layers panel here, and I'm going to Shift and hold to select all three of these ellipses here. Go back up to Quick Effects. I actually like to add a little bit of an outer shadow to these. It makes them look like they're floating above the eye, so a little bit more on the surface of the eye. I like the way that looks. So we're going to go ahead and just pull this radius out a little bit. Just enough, just to get a little bit of that drop shadow, but nothing too crazy. Again, we're going to hit the cogwheel, scale with object. You can also use your layer effects from this panel here. So we'll come with these three ellipses still selected. I want to add an outer glow to them as well. And you'll see that by upping the radius of the outer glow, gives us that cool glowing effect to the eye. It really makes it kind of pop and shine. It really works well with that specular highlight, in my opinion. I'm going to take my three ellipses and I'm going to drag them into our eye shape here. All right, and just like that, you have an eyeball. So pretty simple, pretty straightforward in Affinity Designer. A lot of it's just manipulating the initial circle that we had and adding some various effects to it in order to get it and give it this kind of three-dimensional feel to it. And with the specular highlights and the bounce light that we added from on either side of the eyeball here, kind of helps give you that feel of the glassy wet eye. So with this eyeball here, we can duplicate it. We'll hold Alt and Shift. Shift in order to keep it in line, Alt to duplicate. I'm going to come up here and flip horizontal. And we have a very cool, cute set of cartoon eyes in Affinity Designer. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more tutorials like this. Please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss any new videos. Until next time.